Racing in dirt is a thrill like no other. Your car flows through the turns. It's like music. You find the rhythm and then dance with danger on the edge of control. The adrenaline courses through your veins, but the whole world melts away until it's just you, the car, and the competition. Be fearless. Hello and welcome to Dirt 4. I'm here to help you get started on your path to becoming a driving legend. Why not tell me a bit about yourself? Let's get the basics set up for you. What kind of experience are you looking for when it comes to driving the car? Welcome to Fitzroy, Australia. This is a great place to get a taste of driving a rally car.
This is an M Sport prepared Ford Fiesta R2. It's front-wheel drive with a sequential gearbox, and although it's got a small engine, it still packs a punch. It's a great car to get started with. I'm gonna count you in like I would at the start of a real stage, so when you hear me say go, hit the gas and get up to speed. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, so let's get a feel for how the car slows down. Back off the gas and you'll see how it decelerates. Once you're done, get back up to speed. We've got a corner coming up. Use your brakes this time to slow down the car and then turn into the corner smoothly. Keep going through the next set of turns. Try to get a rhythm going. To help you navigate the road ahead, you'll need to listen to my notes. We'll use the 6-to-1 system. A 6 is a fast and sweeping turn, and a 1 is a slow and tight. Right 6, and left 5 over crest. 80 through dip, 80. Left 5. Into right 4. And left 3 over crest. Don't cut. Into right 5. Dip, crest. A couple of other descriptors you might hear are square, hairpin, and acute. For these corners, you may want to use the handbrake. Try it out at the junction coming up. Dip, right 5, crest, turn, hairpin left, bumps, 60. Great, I hope that all makes sense. I'm gonna give you route notes for the rest of the stage so that you can get a proper taste of stage rallying. Right 5, long. Caution, crest, jump maybe. Right 5. Dip. Bump, bridge. 100 through dip and crest, jump maybe. 80 over finish. Alright, get her to the control. And that's done.
Very impressive. Based on your performance, I think the pro difficulty level.
tire during a rally stage, you have two options. Stop to repair it, or limp the car to the end of the stage. Sometimes driving it out is your only choice, like when you don't have a spare. And it may be faster to limp it home than to spend the time making the change. When you're driving with a flat tire, the car is going to be unstable and prone to understeer and oversteer. This can be especially problematic on two-wheel drive cars when the puncture's on a driven wheel, like when you get a rear flat on a rear-wheel drive car. When a tire goes flat, it loses its shape and it gets floppy. If you keep driving on a flat, the tire can come right off the rim or rip apart, which can lead to bigger problems. The faster you drive, the worse it is. There are a couple of signs to look out for that tell you you're driving too fast on the tire. First, you'll feel a vibration through the car that gets worse with speed. To help prolong the life of the tire, try slowing down to a speed that reduces that vibration. Second, a flat tire is noisy. That's because it's out of shape and it's rubbing in the wheel arch. Again, reducing speed can stop the noise and help keep your tire from breaking apart. Throttle control is super important, especially for rear-wheel drive vehicles like this one. When accelerating out of tight turns, use partial throttle to limit oversteer and try to avoid mashing the gas until you've straightened out. Through long, fast corners, use as much gas as possible to keep your speed up, but back off to control slides when they happen. Once you're confident, apply more gas to find the car's limits and get faster. When you're trail braking, you want to release the brake while you're adding steering. That shifts the weight forward, allowing you to take the turn at speed. Learning to manage weight transfer will help you with more advanced techniques, like the pendulum turn. Trail braking can be a necessity if there's not enough time to brake in a straight line. To make a pendulum turn here, steer away from the corner, brake, and then countersteer sharply into the corner to hit the gas. This throws the weight across the car, allowing a quick change of direction. Use this technique to link corners at speed. For very tight corners, you can combine a pendulum turn with a quick hit on the handbrake at the apex to tighten the line. the start is an art all in itself. In rally, it's not uncommon for drivers to be separated by a tenth of a second at the end of a stage. So a good start could be the difference between winning and losing. In rallycross and land rush, a fast start is even more important. If you get out front first, you'll be clear of the rest of the cars when they hit the first corner together. Turning off the automatic starts assist gives you more control on the start. For manual starts, you need to hold the handbrake while you build up your engine revs, then release it when it's time to go. By default, the clutch works automatically, so there's usually a fraction of a second delay between the time you release the handbrake and when the clutch engages. Through experience, you're going to be able to anticipate this delay and release slightly before go time, giving you a faster start off the line. You need to be confident in your ability to anticipate, though, or you're going to get a penalty for jumping the start. Enabling the manual clutch gives you total control over when you engage the clutch. With practice, this is the fastest way to start, because you're going to be able to time it exactly right. But you need to be more aware of the surface you're on, because each one calls for a slightly different technique. Dry gravel requires the least precision. Dumping the clutch spins the wheels, digging you into the ground where you should find traction right away. Wet conditions can be a little tricky because you might find mud under your wheels that doesn't offer much grip, so you'll want to go easier on the clutch. Tarmac requires you to feed in the clutch progressively, since the shock of dumping the clutch can damage the drivetrain. Snow also requires a different approach. Too much clutch and you'll be spinning your wheels. So allow the car to roll forward slowly to establish grip, and then feed in the clutch to gain speed and avoid wheel spin. On long straightaways like this, climb up through the gears to get the fastest speed possible. For long sweeping turns, downshift before you turn in. Take the next two tight turns in first, accelerating into second between them. Timing your gear changes is critical. Watch for wheel spin, don't shift up too soon. Work your way back up the gears, shift down for the first turn, and again for the next one. When you've got better traction on a paved surface, you can move through the gears faster. Drop to second the final turn. Lower sections, the steering is responsive because your driven wheels are also the ones that are doing the steering. When you're dealing with oversteer, try to resist overcorrecting because you might turn the wheels too far and suddenly snap the car around the other way. Instead, point the wheels where you want to go and floor it. The rear wheels are gonna follow the front. When you're comfortable you can save it from spinning, why not try initiating a little oversteer with the handbrake through a few turns to practice? Thank you. drive cars have a tendency to oversteer when you're on throttle, so controlling your inputs is crucial to maintaining stability. If you feel the car is understeering through tight turn, you can give it more gas to bring the back end around, but be ready to countersteer. Avoid heavy weight transfer because it can be hard to recover from a slide without totally losing momentum. Try to keep your drifts to shallow angles and carefully manage your inputs to control the amount of oversteer. Gives you traction at all four corners of the car, so you can approach turns at higher speeds and throw the car in more aggressively. Don't be afraid to get on throttle earlier through a corner to maximize your speed. You're more likely to face understeer than oversteer because your front wheels are driven. So think about weight transfer when you throw the car into a corner and manage your gas and brake to control the angle. Surfaces, the car's going to change direction slower and slide more before regaining traction. Adjust your racing line to compensate for conditions. To regain traction when the car is sliding, try to balance the throttle to limit wheel spin and regain traction on a loose surface. When you're sideways, you can adjust your slip angle with the gas and the brakes.
Thank you.
much harder to break traction on a paved surface compared to a loose one. Try to push as hard as you can using smooth, sweeping racing lines to maintain speed through the turn. A little bit of tire squeal is a good sign that you're pushing the car to its limits, but if you feel the wheels starting to slide, try to ease off. Keep a smooth line. Sometimes you can make up time by skipping over the apex, but watch what's under your wheels. Obstacles like curbs can unsettle the car. A quick jab of the handbrake can break traction and help get you around tight hairpins.
Of snow surfaces and a variety of grip levels, but the distribution of the grip tends to be more uniform across the width of the road than you'll find with gravel. A typical snow surface features a layer of snow over ice, gravel, or tarmac. Your tires are going to naturally sink into the snow, making a big roost behind the car. A buildup of snow against the side of the tire gives you some resistance to slides and the illusion of a grippier surface. That resistance will subtly slow your forward motion, too. You'll also find patches of compacted snow, a much harder surface the tire doesn't sink into. It's gonna feel like it has less grip, but it's actually faster. When you hit slushy snow, you'll see the color of the underlying road surface showing through the racing line. Grip's gonna be inconsistent across the road as you transition between slush and snow, so your best bet is to stick to the worn tracks whenever you can. Built up along the side of the road are the famous Swedish snowbanks. You gotta watch out, because they'll grab the car if you hit them too hard, and that'll be the end of your rally. But you can use them, too. If you drag the tail of your car through them, they'll help keep you straight on corner exits. Careful, though. There's a fine line between brushing the bank and digging in, which makes this one of the most advanced snow driving techniques you can master. Throughout your career, weather's gonna play a huge part in your successes and your failures. You'll experience sun, rain, mist, fog, and snow, all with varying degrees of intensity. The characteristics of the track surface are gonna change from stage to stage, and sprawling vistas suddenly change from beautiful scenery to deadly sheer drops hidden behind a thick layer of fog. Each condition demands your respect and requires a different approach to driving. Sunny conditions give you the best visibility of the track ahead, and if it hasn't rained recently, the surface will also be dry. In rally, push hard when it's sunny and dry to make up for time lost in wet conditions or to gain an advantage if the weather changes. In rallycross and land rush, visibility can actually be worse due to the dust and debris kicked up from dry, loose surfaces. Try different lines to avoid getting lost in your opponent's dust. Wet conditions reduce grip levels, and depending on how heavy it's raining, can impact visibility. In rally, put your faith in your co-driver in low visibility conditions and adjust your attack to compensate for the reduced grip. In rallycross and land rush, visibility will be better on loose surfaces, but settled water on pavement is going to cause a lot of spray. Fog is only a consideration in rally. When it occurs, it can severely reduce your visibility, and it'll test the trust between you and your co-driver. Keep an eye out for any obstacles beyond your co-driver's control, like stranded cars, and consider taking it slightly easier in these conditions if you can. Snow is exclusive to Sweden, and it's one of the most challenging surfaces you can drive. Your car's going to be surprisingly capable in its snow setup, but the snowbanks and overplow at the side of the road can be punishing if you get offline. Managing wheel spin with careful throttle control is key to maintaining traction. If snow is falling as you drive, visibility can be a challenge, so consider when to push and when to play it safe. Driving a night stage can be one of the toughest challenges in rally. With corners and obstacles obscured by darkness until the lights pick them up at the last second, you need to put your complete trust in your co-driver to continue to post fast stage times. Supporting your main headlights, an additional light pod is attached to your car for night stages. This casts a far stronger beam, adding a lot of illumination to the road ahead. It's important you don't damage your lights during the stage, otherwise you'll find yourself in pitch black in the middle of nowhere. If there's no service area before a night stage, be careful where you put the front of the car. Any serious damage could also prevent the light pod from working when it's attached. If you do have damaged lights when you get to the service area, check the event details to determine if there's a night stage coming up. If there is, your lights can be repaired by fixing the body lights component in the service area. Your crew chief will also prioritize your lights if you ask him for his recommendations. To negotiate corners that come immediately after jumps, you need to make sure you're at the right speed before takeoff. So I'm heading straight toward the jump. I'm watching my speed, and I'm making sure I can land in the right place to take the corner without hitting the red markers. Thank you. drive into water at speed or on an angle, you'll feel resistance against the car that affects your trajectory. Try to adjust your racing line and anticipate your speed. Watch out that you don't hit the water too hard, or it could really tear up your car. Two types of road camber, positive and negative. Positive camber is when the road is sloped toward the inside of the corner. It can be used like banking through the corner for higher cornering speeds. Negative camber is when the road surface is sloped away from the inside of the corner. This naturally tries to force the car away from the apex, pushing you wide, so you want to use lower speeds. Your co-driver will warn you with an off-camber call. In isolation, camber or off-camber corners are pretty easy to deal with, but when they're combined in a sequence of turns, it can be tricky, especially when you're on a road with crown in the middle, and you get both types together. Be careful, because if you get on the wrong side of it, the car can become unstable. Good car positioning is the key to getting the most out of each type of camber.
By completing your induction at the Dirt Academy, you've earned your first license. This has given you access to regional rally events over in Michigan, where you can start your career. Welcome to the home of Dirt 4. From here, you can choose events to find the on-track action. My Team becomes available once you buy a car of your own, allowing you to set up and manage your own racing team. Choose vehicles to find your garage and buy new cars for your collection. From time to time, you will receive messages in your mailbox. Lastly, choose options and extras to find extra content or configure your game preferences. This is your hub for getting on the track. Choose career to start your path to glory. Alternatively, pit yourself against your friends and other drivers in competitive or multiplayer. In free play, you can customize your own championships and even create your own stages. The Dirt Academy is the place to practice and learn new skills. And Joyride puts those skills to the test in a series of technical challenges. In rally, competitors race one at a time down a section of road called a stage. Stages vary in length and can be bumpy, twisty, and have multiple surfaces ranging from gravel to asphalt and snow. To be successful, you'll need a high level of concentration, listening to your co-driver, and maintaining your nerve to push the car to the edge of its performance. An event is made up of one or more stages with service intervals to repair your car along the way. The fastest combined time across the stages wins the event. Your goal is to win the Global Rally Series and take your place among the best.
Recky brought up a couple sections here we gotta watch out for. Good luck. Five, four, three, two, one, go. Keep left over crest, 60. And right 6. And left 5, 40, through dip. Right 6 over crest, don't cut. Right 6, into left 4 long, opens, keep in. 150, keep right over crest. 110 over bumps, 60. Right 5, don't cut, and right 4, don't cut. 100, left 4, and right 6, into left 5. Right 4, long, don't cut, and right 6, don't cut. 200, 200 over bumps, 100. Left 6, don't cut. And left 4, long, 250, 200 over bumps. And right 6, and left 5, 40, through dip. Right 6 over crest, 200, 200 over bumps, 80. Right 4, long, and right 6, 250, to finish. All right, take her slow to the control. Awesome result. That was unbeatable.
Impressive. You've earned a new license and progressed from a local to a regional level. This is a great start to your career. Compete in national championships until you've completed enough events to graduate to an international license.
Hey, if we want to enter more prestigious competitions, we're going to need to get a good ranking going in. Five, four, three, two, one, go. Right 6 over crest, don't cut, 200. 200 over bumps, 100. Yeah, the brakes feel okay to you? Right 5. And right 4, 200. Right 6 over crest, 80. And right 6. And left 5, 40, through dip, water splash. Right 6 over crest. Left 6, through dip, right 5. And left 6, 200. Left 6 over crest, dip, 80. Left 4, and right 6, into left 5, right 4, long, don't cut, and right 6, don't cut, 200, left 4, long, keep in, don't cut, 150, right 4, long, tight, Keep in. Into left six, don't cut. Left six, and right four, and bump, and left six. Right six, don't cut, and bump, and left four, and right six, 200 to finish. All right, take her slow to the control. Perfect, good job, well done. Nothing big from the marshal, we should just get a clear run. Five, four, three, two, one, go. 200 over bumps to 50. Right four long, keep in, don't cut, 60. Right six, don't cut, and bump. And left four, and right six, 80, left four, and right six, into left five, and right six, and left five, 40, through dip, water splash, right six over crest, right four, long, don't cut, and right six, don't cut, 80, crest, 60, turn, acute right, 60, poke, outside. Keep left over crest. Left five, 150. Left four, long. Keep in, don't cut, 200. Left four, long. Keep in, don't cut, 100. Right four, long. And right six, 250. 200 over bumps, 200. 200 over bumps, 250. 200 over bumps, 150. Over finish to stop. Okay, take it to the control. Awesome result. That was unbeatable.
Keep up the good work. With this new license, you've progressed from a regional to national level, and you're ready for the next level of competition.
Afraid she won't let me down. I'm afraid if I try something crazy, I'ma end up in love, love, love. If the world that we live in is crazy and it's difficult to trust, trust.
Once you have enough money, you can choose to buy a car and start your own team, taking the risks and rewards to a greater level. The choice is yours.
Thank you.
Nothing big from the marshal. We should just get a clear run. Five, four, three, two, one, go. Keep left over crest. 200. 200 over bumps. 100. Keep right over crest. 110 over bumps. 200. Right three. Into left six. Left six through a dip. Water splash. Right five. In left six. Left four. And turn left two. 200. Right four long. Keep in. Don't cut. 250. 200 over bumps. Right five, don't cut, and right four, don't cut, 60. Left three long, keep in, 200. 200 over bumps, 200. Left four long, keep in, don't cut, 100. Right five, and right four, 60. Left six, and left four long, 150. Turn, open, hairpin right, don't cut. And right five. Left five, left six through a dip, right five, logs outside. And left six, 200, 200 over bumps. Left three long, keep in, 250. Right six over crest, 200. To finish. Okay, take it to the control. Great stage. Good work. Sounds like there's been an accident on stage, so watch for those triangles. Five, four, three, two, one, go. 110 over bumps, 200. 200 over bumps, 250. Left six over crest, dip. And right six, into left three, 130. Right four long, tightens, keep in. Into left six, don't cut, 150. Right four long, keep in, don't cut, 60. Right five, keep right over crest, 60. Turn, acute left, 60. Crest, 200. Right four long, keep in, 80. Left six. And left four long, 100. Right four long, don't cut. And right six, don't cut, 250. 200 over bumps, 100. 100 over bumps. crest 100, 200 keep middle over jump, cattle grip 80, left 5 60, over finish. All right, get her to the control. Perfect, good job, well done. Hey, if we do well here, we should be able to enter some higher profile events. Five, four, three, two, one, go. 110 over bumps, 150. Left four, long, keep in, don't cut, 150. Left four. And right six, into left five. Left five, 60, turn, acute right. And right six long, 250. Left six, over crest, dip. Right five, left five, and turn, open, hairpin left, 200. Right four long, keep in, 60. Right five, and right four, 60. Left six, and right four, and bump, and left six. Right five, and right four, pose outside, 60. Left six, don't cut. And left four, long, 80. Right five, keep right over crest, 60. Turn, acute left, 60. Crest, 150. Right four, long, tightens, keep in, don't cut. Into left six, 150, over finish. Okay, take it to the control. Awesome result. That was unbeatable.
Troy Green. Yeah, I was right all along. Yeah, you can tag it along. Every day on the train, what you say, I'm throwing it in
the face. Hey, if we want to enter more prestigious competitions, we're going to need to get a good ranking going in. Five, four, three, two, one, go. Right four, through dip, keep middle over crest. Left five. And right six. And left five, 40, through dip. Right six over crest. Don't cut. right 4, long, don't cut, and right 6, don't cut, 80, right 5, keep right over crest 60, turn acute left 60, crest 60, left 6, and left 4, long to 50, 200 over bumps, 130. Open hairpin right, don't cut. And right 5. Left 5. Right 4, long, don't cut. And right 6, don't cut. 100. Left 6, don't cut. And left 4, long, 200. Right 4, long, keep in. 100. 110 over bumps. Keep left over crest, 60, right 5, don't cut, and right 4, don't cut, 60, right 6, don't cut, and bump, and left 4, and right 6, 80, left 4, and right 6, into left 5, 150, 200 over bumps, 60, right 6, don't cut, and bump. And left 4, and right 6, 150, turn, open, hairpin, right, post, outside, 60, and right 6, and left 5, warning, through dip, right 6 over crest, don't cut, left 6, don't cut, and left 4, long, 80, right 5, keep left over crest, jump, maybe, over finish, to stop. All right, get her to the control. Awesome result. That was unbeatable.
This is a major step in your career. You're now qualified to compete in Land Rush and take to the track in buggies and trucks. Great one. You've earned plenty of cash now, so it's time to consider buying a vehicle of your own, which will pave the way to starting your own team. Choose vehicles from the home menu to find one to buy. Thank you. Nice choice. This is a great car. Now you can enter into championships with your own team and earn a lot more recognition. Running your own team can be challenging, but the rewards are much greater. The best part of having your own team is branding it with your choice of pattern and colours. We'll apply the same branding to all your cars. You can come back to the branding suite to change the look of your team at any time.